gotta go with me. It's gonna be the quiz game of the year. Lefty Grohman is pitching, and... Why can't you?
Dancing. Who wants to dance with girls?
What's so good about them?
I never saw a girl yet who could pitch as good as Lefty Grohman.
Well, okay. So long.
Sissy.
Good morning.
Women.
Never mind, Sir Galahad. I'm not falling for that one.
Gee, Marge, you sure look pretty. I guess you're just about the prettiest sister in the whole world. How'd you like to go to the ball game with me Saturday night?
No.
Okay for you, horse face.
Good morning, Margie.
Good morning, Bertie.
Morning, Leroy.
Good morning, Bertie, dear. Oh, boy, my favorite breakfast. Good old oatmeal.
I'm not going to the ball games either.
Good morning, Leroy. Good morning, Marjorie.
Hi, Auntie. How are you?
How is he? He's feeling wonderful.
How can you tell?
Because you look so wonderful. Anybody who looks the way you do must feel great.
Well, thank you, Leroy. I have been feeling well lately.
Good morning, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Good morning, Bertie.
You don't look so good. Have you been getting enough sleep lately?
Yeah, but Bertie, Leroy,
You've got to get to bed earlier, that's all. You need your rest.
Don't listen to Bertie, Unc. You look wonderful. You look just wonderful.
Oh, Leroy, why don't you stop beating around the bush and just ask him?
Ask me what?
Nothing, Unc. I just thought maybe you and I hadn't been seeing much of each other. And,
yes?
And since we always have so much fun when we go out together. And,
yes?
Well, I just thought maybe you and I could...
Leroy, why don't you ask your uncle to take you to the ball game?
Blabbermouth!
Leroy!
A guy doesn't get a chance to use a little fun around here.
You watch your language, young man. Now, what's this about a ball game?
It should be a great game, Unc. Lefty Grohman is pitching. There are still plenty of good seats.
When is it?
Saturday night.
Oh, I'm sorry. I can't go, my boy. I'm going to be doing a little pitching on my own. I've got a date with Eloise.
That's the trouble with this house. Everybody's girl crazy except me, Bertie, and Marjorie.
What's the matter with him?
I guess Leroy's disappointed because he'll have to go to the game by himself.
Oh, now, Marjorie, he can get one of his little school chums to go with him.
I don't think so. It's class party Saturday night, and they're all going to there.
Class party? Wasn't he invited?
Sure, but he won't go because he doesn't know how to dance.
Doesn't know how to dance? That's no problem.
Well, to Leroy it is.
He can learn to dance. The simplest thing in the world.
Well, maybe so, but who's going to teach him?
Well, anyone can teach him. It's simply a matter of patience and understanding.
It is?
Certainly. Tonight, right after dinner, I'll roll back the rugs, turn on the record player, get out the records,
yes,
and then you can teach him to dance.
Thanks a lot, Oki, but nothing doing. Besides, to get Leroy to put his arms around his own sister, you'd have to handcuff him. Bye-bye.
Bye, my dear. Bertie, this is the most delicious oatmeal I've ever tasted.
Thank you, Mr. Gildersleeve. Sorry, but I can't teach Leroy to dance either.
I'm back, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Oh, good, Betty. Did you go to the library?
Yes, sir. I hope these are what you wanted.
Yeah, let me see. Guess no one's taken this out in some time.
I guess people aren't interested in learning how to do the bunny hug anymore.
Bunny hug?
I got all the books they had on dancing. Choose your weapon.
Well, don't poo-poo the Peabody. Well, that's no good, Bessie. The castle walk for home and industry. Bessie, this is a book on cement work.
Oh, it must have been in the wrong section.
Simplified Guide to Ballroom Dancing. Well, this is more like it.
Well, what do you want to learn ballroom dancing for? Are you going to start up a vaudeville act or something?
I'm doing this for Leroy.
You mean you're learning how to dance for him? Oh, you're such a good uncle.
Betsy, I know how to dance. I'm doing it to try and teach Leroy.
Oh, well, I could teach him how to do the Charleston if you want me to.
Betsy!
I'm sorry, Mr. Gildersleeve. I guess I am a little rusty. You know, I once won second prize in a Charleston contest.
Oh?
Of course, I would have won first if I'd had a partner.
That's enough, Betsy. I'll call you when I need you.
Yes, sir.
Ballroom dancing is based on one step, the box step. If you can master this step, you can dance. Seems simple enough. Stand with both feet together. Move left foot forward approximately 20 inches. Move right foot forward to the same distance and parallel to the left foot so that the 2 feet are 20 inches apart. Now I'll bring the left foot over smartly to meet the right foot.
Did you call me, Mr. Gildersleeve?
No, Betsy.
You said you would if you wanted me.
Well, I don't.
Oh. Well, carry on.
The gentleman should approach his prospective partner, bow from the waist, and ask, may I have this dance? May I have this dance? Such familiar terms as kiddo, honey, or cutie are not considered polite. Oops, sorry. If the lady remains silent and just flutters her fan, do not be dismayed. Try again. Faint heart never won fair maiden. May I have this dance? Thank you. Hold your partner closely, but discreetly. When the orchestra starts playing, start to dance. My Bonnie lies over the ocean. My Bonnie lies over the sea. One, two, one, two.
May I cut in?
You're certainly not. Can't you see I need your
poet? Well, Commissioner, I see your taste in women is improving.
Polly, what do you want?
I hate to break in on such a lovely couple, but your girlfriend and I have a date with the washroom floor.
Yeah, I was just brushing up on some steps so that I could teach my nephew Leroy to dance. What's so funny, Foley?
I was just thinking of the dancing exhibition you put on at the Christmas party.
You mean when Betsy and I were doing the Viennese waltz?
You almost won first prize for the mambo.
Foley, that is not true.
It is true.
Oh, hello, Judge.
Foley is right.
You didn't even hear what he said.
It doesn't make any difference. Whatever he said, he's right.
What I said was that at the Christmas party, the commissioner was doing the Viennese waltz, and he almost won first prize for the mambo.
Foley.
I was just leaving. If you need Gladys again, just whistle. Cheers.
Yeah, the castle walk for home and industry. Planning on doing some cement work?
No, I'm going to teach Leroy how to dance.
On what cement?
Never mind your snide remarks. I'm doing this for Leroy.
Why don't you give the kid a break? Take him to some school where he can really learn how to dance.
I can teach him anything he needs to know.
It's 1 minute after, and I guess she isn't coming, so let's go on.
Leroy.
Do I have to?
It's for your own good, my boy. I could have taught you myself, only... well, I'm afraid I'm too advanced for the simple basic steps.
Okay. But you're going to come in with me, aren't you, Unc?
No, Leroy, I'm afraid you'll have to go this alone.
But, Unc, I...
You don't need me around. It's time you started doing things on your own. Yes, well.
And I take it this is Leroy.
Hi.
Well, we might as well get started. You come with me, Leroy. Would you like to wait out here, Mr. Gildersleeve?
Well, perhaps I'd better go with you, just for this first lesson. No need to make Leroy go it alone.
Thank you. Won't you have a seat, Mr. Gildersleeve?
You're all righty. Right here near the dance floor, huh? You go right ahead, Leroy. Just pretend I'm not here.
Now, Leroy, the first thing you must learn is the proper way to hold your partner. There. Now, you hold my hand with your left hand and put your other hand around me.
Leroy, do as Missy Bond says.
All right.
Oh, not so far away.
That's better.
Now, relax. Come on, relax. Afraid I'll bite you?
Miss Ivan, may I have a word with you, please?
Excuse me.
Pardon us, my boy.
What is it, Mr. Gildersleeve?
I don't like to interfere, but I think there's something you should know about Leroy.
Yes?
The boy looks up to me a good deal.
Oh?
So, it might be a good idea if you would dance with me, and then Leroy would have more incentive to do things right.
All right. Now, Leroy, your uncle and I are going to put on a little demonstration for you. We'll start with the simplest step there is. One, two, three, four. All right, Mr. Gildersleeve, the step I just showed Leroy.
Yeah, all right. Now, Leroy, watch how I hold Miss Yvonne. Relaxed, but firmly.
As you say, Mr. Gildersleeve, relax.
Oh, yes.
Now, shall we begin?
All right.
Watch.
Excuse me. Now, watch Leroy.
One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four.
Yeah, now you see how it's done, Leroy.
Let's see you try, Leroy. One, two, three, four. Why, Leroy?
No, Leroy. Now watch how I do it again. One, two, three, four. One, two.
Twinkletoes.
Well, cut it out.
I understand you're going for another lesson tonight.
That wasn't my idea.
Leroy, you didn't finish your dessert. Is something wrong?
No, I wasn't hungry.
I thought dancing was good for the appetite.
From the way your uncle ate, you'd think he did all the dancing. You sure you don't want this cake?
No, thanks, Bertie. Well, I don't see why I have to take 10 lessons. It isn't fair.
Now, Twinkletoes, practice makes perfect.
I told you to cut that out.
Leroy, you shouldn't be angry. After all, your uncle is doing this for your own good. He's giving up his valuable time so you can learn to dance.
I think it's very noble of Uncle Morris.
Remember, he's doing this for you, not for himself.
Ready, Leroy?
Wow, you look beautiful.
Thank you.
My.
Hey, come on, my boy, let's go.
But, Uncle, we're a half hour early.
Well, I thought we might stop and get Miss Yvonne some flowers. It might help me, you, make faster progress. Come on, hurry up. Run along. Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Bye. I told you about that man. There's nothing he wouldn't do for Leroy.
One.
Loosen up, Leroy. Perhaps if I try.
That's fine, Leroy.
Oh, well, fine.
Yeah, thanks.
Leroy, the hour's almost up. Would you mind waiting in the other room? I'd like to talk to your uncle.
Well, go ahead, Leroy. Yes, Miss Yvonne, you want to set Leroy's next appointment? Shall we say tomorrow afternoon?
That's what I wanted to talk to you about, Mr. Gildersleeve. I don't think Leroy needs any more lessons.
Yeah, how about 3 o'clock?
He doesn't really want to learn to dance. You must know that.
But...
And there's no point in forcing him. He has such fine natural ability. It'd be a shame to make him think of dancing as a chore.
Yeah, but what about the dance Saturday night?
Oh, he's learned enough to get by. One or two steps is all boys his age need. I'm sure he'll do fine.
He's got 8 lessons left.
Where'll we fund the money?
You mean... this is the end?
Oh, no. I'm looking forward to seeing you again.
Oh, really?
Certainly I am. When you come back with Leroy, in about 2 or 3 years.
I told you for the 100 millionth time, Monk, I'm not going back for any more dancing lessons.
Leroy, you're making a very big mistake. You'll regret this the rest of your life. Won't he, Marjorie?
I don't think so, Uncle Morty. He has plenty of time to learn to dance.
Well, that's what Miss Yvonne said.
He'll feel inferior to all his friends, won't he, Bertie?
I don't think so, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Most boys Leroy's age can't do but one or two steps.
That's what Mrs. Vaughn said.
If he doesn't want to learn, there's no point in forcing him.
Right.
But Leroy will do just fine at that dance. Most boys his age can't do but one or two steps.
Right.
But
why don't we just forget the whole thing, Uncle?
I think that's a good suggestion.
But let's just drop the whole subject and don't say any more. Leroy will do just fine at that dance. Most boys his age can't do but one or two steps.
Very well. I only had the boy's best interest in mind. You know that, don't you, Leroy?
Yes, Unc.
Marjorie?
Oh, yes, Uncle.
Bertie?
Oh, yes, Mr. Gildersleeve. I know you were thinking of Leroy's own good.
Thank you.
If you want to see that Miss Yvonne so badly, why don't you go down there and take a few dancing lessons yourself? Most boys, Leroy, they can't do but one or two steps.
Miss Yvonne?
Why, Mr. Gildersleeve, this is a surprise. Won't you have a seat?
Thank you. I wanted to continue our conversation about Leroy.
I thought we had that all settled.
Yeah, I've been thinking a lot about you. Yeah, I mean, about Leroy's dancing. And I've come to a conclusion.
Yes?
Since little Leroy looks up to me so much, I can't take his problems too lightly. I have to be completely unselfish about it, even though it means making the supreme sacrifice.
The supreme sacrifice?
Yes. So Leroy can keep his interest alive and not lose contact with the whole world of dancing, I've decided to take lessons myself.
Well, if that's the way you want it, and you could use the lessons.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I want to sign up for the complete course.
The complete course?
Sure.
Well, that includes the waltz, foxtrot, mambo, rumba, samba, and square dancing.
That's right. The whole works. Leroy's welfare is at stake.
Are you absolutely sure?
Yeah, absolutely. When I go into something, I go into it with my whole heart.
Very well, Mr. Gildersleeve. Now, here's a contract for 60 lessons. You sign right here.
Good. When can we begin?
Tomorrow at 6?
I'll be here with bells on.
Now, about the bills.
Oh, send it to my office. Goodbye. Betsy! Betsy!
Yes?
Is Judge Hooker here yet?
No, sir.
Well, what's keeping him? Try his office.
I did try his office. He's not there.
Well, try it. Try it again.
Yes, sir. Oh, excuse me, Judge Hooker. I've got to try your office.
What for?
Well, to see if you're there. Oh, that's silly. If you're here, you're not there. Shall I cancel the call, Mr. Gildersleeve?
Bessie, please. Come in, Judge.
What's the matter?
I need a lawyer.
What'd you do?
Here, come here and sit down, Judge. Here, read that bill.
Miss Yvonne's dance studio. Not bad.
Hey, stop sniffing and start reading.
Complete course of dancing, 60 lessons at $10 a lesson, $600.
Real nice.
You know what that means? It means I'm stuck for $600. And it's all your fault.
What do you mean it's my fault?
You were the one that recommended I go to a dancing school.
I didn't recommend that you go. I recommended that Leroy go. Oh, I see. Is she pretty?
She's gorgeous.
Well, then pay the $600.
I haven't got the $600.
Well, then call them up and tell them.
But I signed a contract for the lessons.
Oh. Gildy, I'm afraid you're up to your old trick. Remember when you signed up for a set of Hawaiian encyclopedias? Oh, was she blonde or brunette?
I don't remember.
Well, you always do what you always fall for, a pretty face.
Well, I'm not made of steel.
Well, you're not made of money either, or you pay my bill.
Judge, get me out of this.
Well, I'll see what I can do. But you signed a contract.
I signed the contract.
Yeah, well, did you sign your full name or just one X?
Just my full name. Throckmorton X. Judge, can you do anything?
Well, I don't know. Maybe we can plead insanity.
Yes. Come on, let's get over there.
Gildy, sit down.
Oh, Judge.
Mr. Gildersleeve. Why, your lesson isn't until 6.
Yeah, Miss Yvonne,
I'll handle this. Miss Yvonne, my name is Hooker.
He's my attorney.
Commissioner, I have something to discuss with you. Is there somewhere where we could talk?
Would you care to step into my private office?
Delighted after you. Don't buy any encyclopedias while I'm gone. Thank you very much.
Did you fix it?
Did I fix it? I'm not an attorney for nothing, except when I work for you.
You'll be paid.
Did you fix it?
She tore up the contract.
Oh, thank you, Judge. Thank you.
That's all right. How'd you do it?
Well, when you know the ins and outs of the law, it's a very simple matter.
Oh, you threw the book at her.
Yes, as we lawyers say, res ipse locta.
Latin, too. You showed her no mercy, huh? I hope you weren't too harsh on her. She's a lovely girl.
Let's say that I was firm but understanding. Now, let this be a lesson to you. You look at the contract before you look at the face.
Don't worry, Judge. You've convinced me.
Oh, Judge Hooker, I checked my schedule. You can start your lessons immediately.
Oh, fine.
Lessons?
Yeah, 60 of them.
Judge.
Well, this is the only way I could save you. She had you dead to rights. I had to take over your lessons at half price.
You're taking dancing lessons with my girl? What a sneaky thing to do.
Well, at these prices, how could I resist? My barley lies over the ocean.
Stop it, Judge. That's our song.
Yeah.
Judge,
yeah.
You're ready for your lessons now.
Good.
And here's your instructor for the complete course. Judge Hooker, I'd like you to meet Miss Pruitt.
How do you do? I've got to come back this way, if you think.
See you later, Judge. See if your Latin will get you out of this. Oh, Bertie, you should have seen the look on Judge Hooker's face when that girl walked out.
He sure outsmarted himself.
He sure did.
Mr. Gildersleeve, what do you want to give Leroy singing lessons for?
Well, it was Leroy's own idea. He wants to get into the school glee club.
I heard Foghorn sound better than that. He won't last through one chorus of My Barney Lies Over the Ocean. You're just wasting your money.
Don't you worry, Bertie. It won't go to waste.
Mr. Gildersleeve, could I speak to you for a moment?
Oh, certainly. Will you excuse us, Leroy?
Oh, sure.
Leroy.
Mr. Gildersleeve, may I speak frankly?
Please do.
Well, Leroy's a lovely boy, but as far as training his voice is concerned, will you understand?
Nothing, huh?
Well, his voice might improve after it changes. That sometimes happens. But in all fairness, right now, I think you're wasting your money.
Oh, well, I'm sorry.
I'll be happy to refund the balance of your money.
No, that won't be necessary.
Oh, but it's almost $150.
What I mean is, I could take over Leroy's lessons. My voice has changed, you know. Just one thing I want to be sure of.
What's that?
You will give me the lessons in person.
Why, of course.
Good. Then it's a deal. Where do I sign?
Oh, that won't be necessary. Your word's good enough for me.
It is? You should be sealed with a handshake?
All right.
Tomorrow night? At 8?
At 8.
I'll get it.
Yeah, thank you, my boy. Is Mrs. Tobin here?
Oh, Mrs. Tobin? Oh, yeah.
Right here, darling.
Darling?
Oh. Well, Mr. Gildersleeve, I'd like you to meet my husband.
Husband? Pleased to meet you.
Good to meet you. Come on, dear. Good night, Leroy.
Good night.
See you tomorrow night at 8, Mr. Gildersleeve. And our first lesson will be My Barney Lies Over the Ocean.
Good night.
Good night.
What's the matter, Unc? You don't look so good.
Yeah, I feel a little seasick.
Thank you.